Seated for a moment. We're glad to see you this morning and appreciate you being here and worshiping with us. Hopefully you got a program when you came in this morning, a bulletin. You can see what's happening. We're starting a single Sunday school class, interactive Bible study. It will start the 19th. It'll be 11:15 at the Pages, Michael and Kathy Pages. And if you need more information, I'm sure they will answer your questions texting or any of that. So this is for all ages, all stages, and anybody that thinks they're single. How about that? Okay? So be aware of that. And then as it's warming up, quickly, really quickly, homemade ice cream sounds great, doesn't it? Well, mark your calendar on Sunday, August the 2nd. We will have our annual homemade ice cream fellowship. That'll be in the gym, and then we'll have a little bit of church business going on after that. And bring your ice cream. And it's always a red letter day when we have ice cream. It's always a fun time and a good time. So be mindful of that. You might want to bring some ice cream too, okay? And Bluebell is accepted. Just we're not prejudiced. But if you want to make homemade, that'd be fine too. So look forward to that and having a great time. Our students are meeting on Wednesdays at 7. Our children are meeting at 6 on Wednesdays. And then we're having the Wednesday night Bible study at 6 in here. And so be mindful of that. If you're visiting, we'd love to have you come back next week and see normal. It'll be a little bit more normal next week with everybody here. But if you are visiting, we would love to know who you are. And so if you would look on the back here, there's a little card that we'd love for you to fill out and tear it off and you leave it in the back as you leave. We'd just like to know who you are, how we can minister to you, and how we can be an asset to you, and we can pray for you. So be mindful of that. We're glad that you're here, and be singing. And we'll have a great time of worship. In the life of our nation, we are celebrating our freedom this weekend. And it's something that we need to celebrate. It's something we should celebrate. It's something that we should be thankful for. Many people have given and provided for that, for us to enjoy that. And so, if you're a veteran, could I ask you at this time to stand, please? Come on, guys. Let's give them a hand. We say thank you, and that sounds really shallow and really trite, but we say thank you for what you have done and what your family has done to enable us to have the opportunity this morning to worship as we please and to have the freedoms that we have as a nation and as a people. We realize that some folks didn't come home, and we're mindful of that, and we lift their families up as they have attempted to put their life back together and to continue on. We thank you for the sacrifice they gave and the families gave as they persevered, continued to step forward. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you for the day. We thank you for this season, Lord. Father, help us to be mindful of our freedoms. Father, help us to remember our freedoms. Father, help us to exercise our freedoms. And Father, we thank you for these men and women that have stepped forward to answer the call to protect these freedoms. Lord, we pray that you would be with those that didn't come home. Father, we pray that you would be with their families. And Lord, we know you've already wrapped your loving arms around them in the past and helped them through this difficulty. And Father, we just ask that you would continue to bless them, continue to bring those memories and those good times that they've had with their loved one. And Father, most of all, we thank you for the sacrifice that they gave to ensure our freedom. Father, we thank you for the freedom that we have through your Son, Jesus Christ. And Father, may we also be mindful of that. And may we live a life that reflects the sacrifice that he gave for us. Thank you, Father, for these. Thank you for the freedoms that we allow through your Son, Jesus Christ. In your name we pray. Amen. Would you stand as we sing America the Beautiful?
Is truly is marching on.
Father, we thank you that you never sleep or slumber and that you're always available 24/7. Father, may we be the people that you would have us to be. Father, again, we thank you for the sacrifice your Son gave for us that we may have freedom. Be with us as we continue to worship. We pray. Okay, I'm going to sit you down if you'll keep singing. Okay? There's always a danger that when you sit, the mouth just closes. There's a great song that says, "Amazing grace, my chains are gone. My chains, we have freedom because the chains are gone." Let's sing this together.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind.
Sometimes when God just kind of drops a bomb on you and you go, boop, wow. never saw that. I never heard that. I've read these scriptures forever. I've sung this song forever. Our last song this morning is God of Grace and God of Glory. If you want to take your hymnal, it's on page 395, because we're going to sing the third verse today in sequence there. I've sung this song all my life. I love it. It's one of those songs, it's almost a battle song that raise the flag, get the sword, and charge. But if you also look at it, it's a prayer. So we're going to sing it first like we always sing it. And then bear with me as we rein it in a little bit. And then on that third verse, I always skip this one. Cure thy children's warring madness. Watching TV lately? Bend our pride to thy control. Shame our wanting selfish gladness. Maybe I ought to quit right there and we'll just sing it. But it seems so apropos for where we are today. Would you stand as we sing God of Grace, God of Glory, 395.
Pray. Dear Lord, just thank you for this day, this beautiful morning with rain. I just thank you for this wonderful weekend where we're able to celebrate our country's freedom. I just thank you for all the freedoms that you've given us, but most importantly, I just thank you for the freedom that we have, freedom of religion, just freedom to come together each Sunday and worship, and I pray that we don't take that for granted. And dear Lord, I just thank you for all the freedoms you give us through dying on the cross for us, and just forgiving us of our sins, dear Lord. And I just pray that this week we're mindful of that. Just pray that you be with our country, be with the health of our country. Be with those who are unable to be here in our service today. Just lift them up. Pray that you lift Brandon up today. Give him the words to speak and to put on our hearts, dear Lord. I ask these things in your name we pray. Amen.
We've sat silent for too long, while the darkness ever strong casts a shadow on this land. But we're the children of the light. We have hope that's burning bright. We weren't made to cower, we were made to stand. Let the church arise. Let us stand for what is holy. Let us stand for what is right and live our lives as a beacon in the night. No, we will not compromise. Let the church, let the church arise. All the trouble in these times doesn't catch God by surprise. He's still sovereign over all. So let the ones who bear his name be bold and unashamed, and with expectation answer when he calls. Let the church arise. Let us stand for what is holy. Let us stand for what is right and live our lives as a beacon in the night. No, we will not compromise. Let the church arise, arise. These are days for the church to be who Christ has made the church to be. Church, arise. Let us stand for what is holy. Let us stand for what is right and live our lives as a beacon in the night. No, we will not compromise. Let the church, let the church, let the church arise.
Let's see if I can get this thing locked in. I don't like a headset, but it's all we've got. I just want to say, I know Pastor did it last week, but we have an incredible sound and video crew up there. If you've never ran sound and know the stresses of that, the ladies use the same mic as the men and adjusting and readjust. It's a lot of work and it's a lot of pressure. And so for them to be able to do that, you know, it's usually the people up there are the ones that don't want recognition. That's why they're up there. But we are grateful for them and what they do week in and week out. Thank you guys so much. Well, some of you may know, some of you may not, we have been selling fireworks for the past 10 days. Starting June 24th, we opened a fireworks stand with the student ministry, and some of you have come and supported, and we are grateful for that. People have asked, well, did you do well? And last night at 9 o'clock, I turned the lights off and shut the stand down because we only had $100 worth of product left. So we basically sold out by 9 o'clock last night. And so that is because of you guys sharing the post, coming buying, coming supporting. A good thing is that next year, hopefully, we have a great setup and great reputation in that spot. Every stand in town sold out. We had people from Longview coming to try to buy fireworks here in Gilmer. Everybody was sold out. And so because of you guys, we were able to do a little bit more for the student ministry. We'll be able to buy some stuff, send some kids to events. And so we're grateful for that. As a student pastor, that takes a load off, knowing you guys supported us. While out there yesterday, Pastor called me, as you know, and about 12 o'clock, he said, "Hey, Brandon, I just want to check on you. You know, are you exhausted yet?" I said, "Well, I'll let you know tomorrow. Depends on how today goes." And he said, "Well, we got a problem." And I said, "Well, I'm probably exhausted then, if that's the case." And he said, "You know, everything that you've heard, you know, are you able to preach in the morning?" And I said, "I can do it, Pastor. No problem." And I began to pray right there. You know, what would you have me to speak about, God? And of course, with it being Independence Day, the first thing is freedom. And then he called me back about 6 o'clock and he said, "Look, if we can figure out a way to record me at my house and post it and play it on Sunday morning, I'm okay with that." And I was like, "Well, that would probably be more work than me just getting up here and preaching." And so we just stuck with the plan. And he said, "Well, I'll just let you know, I plan on preaching on freedom. Don't feel like you have to, but that's what I was going to preach on." And I said, "Well, I've already been praying about it. I've got some stuff going, and that's kind of what the direction I'm headed." And so God already had this in motion. He already knew what was going to happen. He already had the plan. And so when I think of freedom, the first thing that comes to mind is Galatians 5:1. And it is for freedom that Christ has set us free. "Stand firm then, and do not let yourselves be burdened again by a yoke of slavery." Father, we thank you for this day. We are grateful for the opportunity to come to a building and worship you without fear. We know that because of the sacrifices that have been made in the past in our country, we have the freedom to worship you. And so right now we just say, Holy Spirit, you have the freedom to invade this room. We ask that you would just speak to us independently and where we're at in life, what we need to hear, and how we need to hear it. You know better than any of us what needs to be heard. So I ask that, Holy Spirit, you would speak through me. Just set Brandon aside and just use me as a vessel to get your plan and your purpose passed in this day. Jesus, we love you. We thank you that you died on the cross for our sins. And it's in your name we pray. Amen. I'll let you know, in the first service, I looked down and it said 10:13, and I thought, oh my goodness, I've got to preach to 11 o'clock. I don't think I have 45 minutes worth of stuff. And I was like, oh wait, we get out at 10:30. I think I can handle that. So we're going to be quick today, guys. It's going to be easy, but I believe this message has depth. As I began to sell fireworks yesterday and we'd have a little break, it's inevitable. It'll be nobody for 30 minutes, and then it'll be 30 people for 1 minute. It's just how it works. And so we would have periods of break, and so I'd pray, or I'd, you know, write stuff down on my phone and kind of go with a direction that I feel like God is going with this message. And so the first thing I did was look up the definition of freedom. What is freedom? If it is for freedom that Christ set us free, then what does freedom mean? And so freedom is the state of not being imprisoned or enslaved. I know many times in my life I've chosen to be enslaved to my own decisions. There's been moments where I look back and go, why did I choose to do that? I've allowed myself, like it says in verse 1, to be burdened again by a yoke of slavery. And I know everybody in this room has suffered that. We all tend to go back to that burden of slavery, that we all have our independent struggles, we all have our independent catches and get-ups that you know, we seem to struggle with. And so I want to talk about the state of not being imprisoned or enslaved. And as I begin to think about this, I begin to think about what is something that all of us can corporately agree on that catches us and keeps us in bondage. And I believe it all starts right here with our mind. I believe it starts with our mind. And the reason I say that is because in Proverbs, it tells us our greatest chain of bondage is our mind. It says, as a man thinketh, so is He. If I wake up in the morning and choose freedom, that I am. As I thinketh, so am I. So the point that I want to talk about today, it's one and done. Freedom is a daily decision. I'll wake up in the morning and choose freedom. As Americans, we understand that. We understand what it means to have freedom. If you go to another country, if you've ever been to another country that doesn't have the luxuries that we have, it becomes more real just how good we have it here. We understand freedom. As believers in Christ, hopefully we understand freedom. But I know there are many times in our life where we can sometimes be a Christian and still allow ourselves to be bondage to certain things in our life. Maybe it's worry. Maybe it's fear. Maybe it's just that one little addiction that we keep going back to. That one person. That one thought. Maybe it's not doing something that God has asked you to do. Maybe it's not so much of stop doing something. Stop having the negative thoughts. Stop thinking those bad things. Stop thinking about, you know, how good you think you're not. But maybe it's starting to do something that God has asked you to do. Maybe it's being obedient. That can be something that holds us to bondage, is not being obedient to God's word, not obeying when He tells you to do something. Go pray for that person. Go give in this area. Go serve in that area. It's not always not doing something. Sometimes it's starting to do something. And so I started to think about, what does it mean when He says, it is for freedom that Christ has set us free? That's like using a word to define a word. How do I use love? I love because I love. Well, what does that mean? I have freedom because I'm free. And so I started thinking about these things, and maybe if we change the wording a little bit, it is because of grace that I have received that I can extend grace to others. Or maybe it is because of love that I have been shown that I can show love to others. It is because of forgiveness that somebody's given to me that I am able to extend forgiveness to somebody else. It's kind of one of those things where it takes money to make money. It takes money to make it. It takes freedom to have freedom. And so I wrote, because of grace that I've received, I can give it. Because of love I have been given, I can show it. Because of forgiveness I have received, I can send it. And because of freedom that Christ lived, I can live it. While we were at the stand, it was getting around 4 o'clock yesterday, and I was out of all my big stuff, all the artilleries, all the stuff. When somebody walks up and goes, I want something that goes bang, I didn't have it. And so a guy walked up and he said, man, I want the bang, I want the biggest, whatever you got. I said, man, I'm sold out, I'm sorry. And he kind of got frustrated. He's like, man, we wanted to support you guys. And I was like, I'm sorry. I thought to myself, I can't give you what I don't have. I would love to. I would love for there to be a shelf stocked full of fireworks up here, because that's more money we're making. And I said, I'm so sorry. Maybe next time. You know, so I sent him to another stand, and right then, God said, Brandon, how many times do you walk around with something holding you down, weighing on you that I didn't give you? I can't give you what I don't have. And so how many of us walk around with that weight that we're not supposed to, because it didn't come from Jesus? Jesus can only give us what He has, and what He has is freedom. I like to call this the beautiful exchange. The Bible tells us that our rags, our riches, are like dirty rags, filthy rags. When our righteousness, when we try to give it, is like filthy rags to Jesus. What we have to offer is gross. And Jesus says, that's okay, I want it. Give it to me. And in that moment, when we give Him our rags, our filthiness, our dirtiness, He says, here's my freedom. I have lived freedom. It says in Galatians that Jesus, who was born under the law, lived in freedom. He walked free so that we could be free. And so today, July 5th, the day after our Independence Day, the day after that we know as Americans what it means to be free, I hope that you know what it means as a Christian to walk in freedom and not have to have the bondage and the heavy weight of this world and your past and your decisions weighing you down. I'm going to tell you the story. Some of you may know this already. Some of you may not. My students know this for sure, but I made a mistake once in my life. I know you, that's for you. You're like, there's no way. You're perfect, Brandon. I've made a mistake one time. As a young man, I decided to get behind the wheel of a car after I'd been drinking all day and got pulled over. And the first thing the cop said was, "Have you been drinking?" And I said, "Yes, sir, I have." And he said, "Will you step out of the car, please?" So I step out, I do the sobriety test, and he said, "All right, last thing, will you blow in this?" And I said, "What happens if I say no? My house is right there. I can throw a baseball and hit my house. Can I just walk to my house?" He said, "It's a yes or no question, son." "I guess not." He said, "All right, turn around. You're under arrest." Put me in handcuffs, put me in the car, took me to jail. On October 4th, I spent a night in jail. A grown man sitting in jail crying, not because I was scared, not because I was afraid, but because I knew what Jesus did for me on the cross and how I abused that time and time again. And in that moment, there's four other men in this jail cell with me. I dropped to my knees and I said, "God, you have got to do something. I can't take this anymore." And that next morning, they call my name. I walk out, I get my stuff, I change clothes, and I open the door to leave. And as I push this door open, the sun hits me in the face. And it's a defining moment that I'll never forget. As I opened the door and I stepped out, it is like the weight of the world was lifted off of me, and I heard God say, "Son, you are free. You are free." The Bible tells us in John, "Whom the Son sets free is free indeed." And this is where we get caught up. We think, okay, we're free. We're good to go. I can just roll. No, freedom is a daily decision. We have to choose it. Because if we're not careful, we'll be back in the bondage of slavery that gets us every time. And here's what's so awesome about that moment. Is that I cannot be good enough to ever receive God's love. Which means I cannot be bad enough for Him to not love me. That's awesome. There's no bar that I have to reach where He says, "Okay, now you've got to this point, now I can love you." Which means there's no depth that I can go to where He goes, "I'm sorry, I can't reach you. You're too far gone." And so in this moment, in this day, as we wrap up, in Galatians 2, it says, Paul says, "I do not set aside the grace of God. For if righteousness could be gained through the law, Christ died for nothing." So in this moment, in this room, all of us, I want you to know that freedom is a daily decision. As a Christian, allow God to set you free every day. Because if not, you'll be burdened again by a yoke of slavery. If we're not careful, we'll be burdened again by whatever it is. Maybe it's guilt because of decisions we made in the past. Maybe it's worry about the future and what's going to happen. Maybe it's fear. All these things, remember, I can't give you what I don't have. All these things God doesn't have, we're carrying around. And so I want to encourage you as Christians this morning that you will allow maybe today to be the day, your Independence Day as a believer, to say, "Jesus, I choose freedom today." Father, we love you. We thank you. We know that you are more than we could ever hope or want or desire or need. We know that you have a plan for us. We know that everything, good or bad, you can use for your glory. And we know that what the enemy chooses for harm, you will use for good if we will allow it. So in this moment, I pray that you would move freely. You have the freedom to move. We don't restrict you. We just ask that you would do what only you can do. Holy Spirit, we're grateful that you give us the power to walk in freedom. Jesus, we thank you that 2,000 years ago you said, I will give my life for their freedom. And because of that, as believers, if we choose to believe in you, we can have freedom. And so we choose freedom right now. We thank you, Jesus, that you died on the cross for our sins. We'll never be able to repay you. We'll never be good enough to earn your love, which means we can never be bad enough. You give it freely and unconditionally, and we thank you for that right now. And Jesus, it's in your name we pray. Amen. As we close, Boyd's going to lead us in Amazing Grace. I'm going to come down front if you would like to talk to somebody. If you keep reading Galatians 5, Paul talks about it. He says, here's the thing about freedom. We experience it by loving one another. By loving your neighbor. We know that the greatest commandment, and this is what's so hard for us as Christians, I believe this is the hardest thing as Christians, is forgiving ourselves. We know God can forgive us. We allow everybody else to forgive us, but we don't forgive us. And so in this moment, I want to remind you that the Bible says to love God with all of your heart, soul, mind, and strength. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. And so I want you to know it's okay to love yourself right where you're at. Your flaws, your failures, your victories, everything. Because God loves you right where you're at. And so if you'd like somebody to pray with you this morning, I'll pray for you, pray with you. If you'd like to come down and say, Brandon, today's the day that I choose freedom. Today's the day I choose Jesus. I'd love to lead you in a prayer. If you want to join the church, you've never done that, you can come down front. I'll talk with you. And then, of course, Pastor will be calling you. If you need anything, I'm just going to make myself available, and then we'll be done.
Together, please. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed.
Father, we love you. We thank you so much. We know that freedom is not free. It come at a cost. And Jesus, it was you that paid that cost. And so we just ask that you be glorified in all that we do this week. Pray that you would be with our pastor and his family. That you would keep them safe and healthy. We just pray that you would help us to love others this week. Give us somebody to love this week. Give us the wisdom and the knowledge to know what to say or what not to say. Thank you, Jesus, and it's in your name we pray. Amen. We love you guys. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful week.